Thanks for coming. I want to give the fans here a little shout out. They did a, this is a great environment to come watch a game, come play a game, and I told Coach that they got a great team, Coach Antonio. So it was a great great opportunity for two good football teams to go play, and very proud of our guys. A young team grew up tonight. I told them in there the future is extremely bright here at Ohio State. There's a bunch of young players out there playing that acted like older players, and really, really proud of them. I'll answer any questions for you.
Front row, Todd.
Urban, after the game, you and Shelley had a moment there, and then it just looked like for the first time maybe in 2.5 season you were able to, like, just exhale. Do you feel like you got that signature win you've been looking for, and did you feel like you could exhale?
Well, me and Shelley have a bunch of moments together. Been married 25 years, so. Yeah, it's a, you know, we won here a couple years. This is a tough place to play. That's an excellent defense out there, and a lot went into this. So if you want to use the term exhale, you can't exhale very long because we're going on the road again next week against a team that whooped Iowa. So, yeah, I mean, we had a great moment there.
Urban, could you talk about the two passes to Michael Thomas and then to Devin Smith, especially yeah. that gave you all the tide and pushed you ahead to stay the Devin Smith pass just before halftime, 44 yards?
Well, it was, you know, their offense, that's the thing that's different about the team we just played, is that as opposed to 2 years ago, this is a dynamic offense. I think he had 300 yards against us. The quarterback's terrific, and the receiving crew, you know, I don't spend a lot of time watching the opponent's offenses, but every Wednesday I do, and I was like, well, my goodness, I didn't realize how good their skill had become in the last couple of years. So JT, we had to answer each one of their hits, and we did. And JT, boy, is he playing well. 16 of 26, 300 yards throwing, and very accurate on the deep balls. And also, Devin Smith, that's his best game that we've had in the last 3 years. And he's the best, if not the best, one of the best deep ball players we've ever had. He tracks the ball very well. And once again, answered their hit, and we had to answer, and we did.
Yes, could you address the offensive line play?
Because, terrific. And Billy Price is a guy that gave up a sack early in the game, and I thought, oh, it's going to be, early in the year we had a little problem where freshman linemen were playing like freshman linemen, and he grew up tonight. And Taylor Decker is the leader of that whole group, and you get that kind of yardage against a defense like that. It all starts, it's always an offensive line-driven team, and that's where all that, you know, Tom Herman did a nice job in that locker room crediting the offensive line with all those yards.
Coach, were you more aggressive on offense? It seemed at times we're going to throw the deep ball. We're going to throw, I don't know if you call it caution to the wind. But did you take the reins off Tom Herman? Did he say something to you this week that?
No, what did you say? I held him back? I'm the one that always wants to do that. No.
Are you?
No, I'm just kidding. Tom and I work together. He's great to work with. So that kind of defense forces you to go over the top. And it's not a defense they challenge. Anytime you play with this press quarters, they call it, very similar to what we play, they force you to go over the top. And we felt like we had some matchups somewhere that if we found them right, that we'd take that shot. And so we had that plan really starting last year. We went into the Big Ten championship game and just missed on some of those. If you remember, we threw it down the field, we just missed. And this year we hit them.
All right. Urban, what do you think that the team proved tonight? Do you, in your mind, is this a playoff team?
Oh, I don't know enough. I think it is because I love my team, and I don't know enough about, I haven't studied the other teams really, but if I have to go fight for this team, what they've done, very impressive. That darn loss, the second game, if that hurts us, then that's I'll take the hit for that because that was a young team that's playing at an extremely high level right now.
Doug. Urban, what do you think this victory meant to your players? What sense did you get from them out there?
This is one for the ages. That's how much respect we had for our opponent going into it. We saw what they did. They had one loss and were actually winning that game until we got away from somehow out at Oregon. So we played a top 10 team and really played our best. And so on the road. So once again, the future. I look at our players. I see how many young guys are playing for. Is going to be around here for a while. So the future is pretty bright.
And last set of questions.
Tim. Urban, and did this statement come at a right time? There were four teams at least in the top 10 today. It got beat. You guys went the other direction. What do you
Good.
Think this means the college football playoff situation?
Do you have a vote? Are you on the playoff committee? I think, you know, I'm glad we got to play in prime time. I'm glad game day was here. I'm glad everybody got to see Ohio State Buckeyes, because this is a different Buckeye team than it was early in the season. When you're playing, I think, six or seven freshmen starting for you, we're a much different team. This team right now is playing on a very, very high level. So I'm not sure what all that means other than we got to get ready to play next week.